We're going to have a great time on this Yom Teruah, the great celebration of the riches and the blessings of Almighty Yom. We're not going to prolong anything at all, but before Zachin Yarameya comes, I want to read a pronouncement unto the nation, his people, the elect, true Israel. That we declares with the proclamation of the Most High, he commands us to shear, to make shiram, to sing unto Yah a hadash, a song that has been regenerated in our bosoms, in our hearts. And the reason why, because he has done marvelous things for us. He has done great things. His right hand, Yahshua HaMashiach, and by his Chadosh, his Kodash arm, his strength, he has given us and gotten us the Teshua, the victory in Yahshua. Yah hath made known his Yahshua, his salvation, the assurance, the power to endure unto the end. His Sadiq, his righteousness, has he openly showed in the sight of even all the heathens, that we obey his commands and keep what he instructs us to do by revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach. He has remembered his hased, his kindness, and his truth toward Beit Yisrael. He knows what we are. He's remembered his kindness toward us. So he gives us and grant us the time and the season to gather and to show our appreciation for his kindness. All the ends of the earth has seen the salvation of Almighty Yah. He commands us, just make. I don't care what it sounds like, make a joyful noise unto Almighty Yah. He commands all the old land to do that. He said, make a loud noise. You hear that? He said, rejoice and sing praises. And not only that, he commands us to sing unto him with the harp and with the voice of the sorcery. And he says this, Yisrael, with the shofar, put them things to your mouths. Come on, Akh Shimriy. He said, with the shofar, 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 Yom Teruah. This is the time we make a joyful noise unto Yah, because he is our Melech. This is the time we make a joyful noise, a strong noise unto him. He said, let the sea roar and the fullness thereof, the world that they dwell therein. He said, let the floods, let the magnitudes of the waves clap their hands. Even the waves clap their hands. He said, let the hills be joyful, hallelujah, together. He said, before Yah, for he cometh to judge us with righteousness. He shall judge the people and the people with equity. He does it right all the time. He does it right all the time. That's why he grants us a day like Teruah, a day like Kippurah, that we may remember the greatness of his kindness and rejoice in all of his abundant righteousness. Come on, Zakein. We're going to hear some preaching today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yabaruch.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shalom and Barak, Kol Yisrael, on this beautiful hug of Almighty Yahweh, this Feast of Trumpets, where the voice like a shofar, it sounds, Kol Yisrael, unto his people, that we may awaken, that we may be enlightened by his mitzvot, his truth, Yisrael, that sounds from Hashemayim like a great shofar that we may hear. We shall continue on this process today, Yisrael, concerning the theme of this Sukkot, this time that we are soon approaching, even this day of the Feast of Trumpets, concerning the fight, the battle of Emunah. We have heard, Akh, those of you that are listening, those of you that may be just tuning in today, Azakim Benjamin Abash and Aat Yawasadat, they spoke on yesterday concerning this battle, the fight. How we shall endure by Emunah. And how we, even as soldiers, as warriors, as Yahshua HaMashiach goes before us, and he has gone before us in the battle, that we may come in, that we will give our life as he gave his life by Emunah. Hallelujah. He has set above all the most greatest of examples before us as being our Zabak, our offering unto Almighty Yahweh. So shall we do unto him, Yisrael, with faithfulness, with Emunah, and with faith. I do want to read this before Akh Yowshibyah, he comes up this morning to present unto us the word from Almighty Yahweh from Torah. And he shall speak for Torah, Yisrael. It says here in Deuteronomy, chapter 32, verse 1. He says, to all give ear, O you Shemayims. He said, and I will speak. Yahweh shall speak to us through his Malach, his messenger today, Yisrael. He said, I will speak. And they shall speak. And hear, O ye Olams, the words of my mouth. Are we not here today to Shemak, to hear? He goes on and said that my doctrine shall drop as the rain, and my speech shall distill as the dew. Distillation, or the water distilling into the ground, is of utmost importance, Yisrael. It's more than just the rain that falls, but it has to penetrate into the ground. It has to get deep into the earth. So as our Akim speak unto us, Yisrael, allow his Torah, his Mishpah, to distill, to soak in, that it may water the innermost parts of our levim, that we produce the zera, the seed that is in us may sprout with life and with an abundance of fruit. So at this time, we do ask our Akh Yowshibyah, if you would come up, please, my Akh, and let us greet him with a hearty hallelujah, Yahweh. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Yahweh. Akh Yowshibyah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Tole Yah for this beautiful occasion, this feast that he has granted us to come and partake. For it is only for us, Yisrael, for our strength and to increase our Emunah that he gives us these days, that we may learn to walk in his ways and to rejoice in all that he has done. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Yahweh. Tole Yah. Even as we sing and dance and we see the children, we see as they dance, as they sing, that we should instill these things in our children, that as it becomes real even in our lives, as they watch us, that it will become real in their lives. As they grow, as they come to understand, that they will have an even more greater understanding and even more of a fire in their loins to serve and to please Yah in all things. Hallelujah. We're going to start here this morning in Maccabees. Fourth Maccabees, chapter 9, concerning the Emunah and the joy and the virtue that comes from the Emunah. Because everything with Yah, he adds. You start with one thing, he adds another. He adds daily, such as should be Yasha.
Yes, that's right.
So we see here in Maccabees 9, verse 31, that the man of Yah says, I lighten my pain.
Yes, all right.
Because in this life you will have pain,
yes.
You will have suffering. You will have tribulations, because it is ordained of Yah that we have these things. But the man of Yah here says, I lighten my pain. It becomes bearable. It becomes a thing that is not even grievous to me. He says, I lighten this pain by one thing, by the joy. And Yah gives joy to his people. His joy, it is our strength. It is our koach. It is that which causes us to be sustained and to be kept. It is the pleasure and the rejoicing only in him.
That's right.
For we know that if we suffer for Sadiqah's sake, then we are happy. It is not something for us to be discouraged about, but if we suffer for Sadiqah, for the crown that Yahweh has placed before us, if we suffer for that, then we are happy. We have the Esha. We are not trodden down. We are not discouraged, but we are happy. He said, by the joys that come from virtue. And that's somewhat what I'm going to speak about, the virtue that comes along, that follows that Emunah. Emunah is the first step. But then as you grow in that, as you grow in the Emunah, the stability, the steadfastness, the assurance of Yah's Torah, then that virtue will come from that. And you know, we all have been taught, the world, the church has taught us what faith is, what virtue is, but their explanation, their definition, it is wrong. They have taught us that faith is something mystical, that I believe for this. I believe, quote, God for this, for a bigger house, for a larger car, for a boat, for a career, for financial security. That is not the Emunah of Yah. The Emunah of Yah is firmness, steadfastness, assurance, security, only in one thing, in his Torah. And when you are firm in that, you're secure in that, you abide in that, then you know that you have the Emunah. Not because of what you have or what you have gained in this world. That is not the Emunah. So, we know that from this Emunah, the steadfastness, comes the virtue. And we have been taught what virtue is. Oh, she's so virtuous. He has such virtue. Oh, he's so pure. He's so gentle and kind. He's so loving. That is not the virtue of Yah. It is completely wrong. It's not the virtue of Yah. These men in Maccabees, they were warriors of the Emunah. If you look in Maccabees, you will see that they went through great torture, great pain, for the sake of just the name of Yahweh. They would not turn back. These men had the virtue. They were warriors. The virtue, the mentality of Yah, it is his high yield. That's virtue, not how pristine that you think you are because I haven't done this or I haven't done the sin that this one's done. I have virtue. That's not the virtue. The virtue is simply the high yield in the Hebraic, the valor, the strength, the power, the substance, the excellence, and the might, and the ability to train your mind in the ways of Yah. That is virtue. That is not this false thing that the world has taught us. That is virtue. And if you have the Emunah, once you garner that, once you get that, then only will you proceed unto the virtue of Almighty Yah. So it says here, I lighten my pain by the joys that come from virtue, from high yield, from the strength, the character of Yah. He said, but you, you vile ones, you evil ones, you ones who are rebellious, who do not want or strive to walk in the ways of Yah, you suffer torture by the threats that come from impiety. You suffer as your own for your own evil doing. Because for every action, there will be a reaction. There will be a reckoning from Yahweh. So if you do evil, you do abominable, you tyrant, you rule over your own flesh with the hand of wickedness, then you're going to suffer for that. And it's not the suffering of Sadiqah. And he says, you will not escape, most abominable tyrant, the judgments. You're not going to escape Yah's judgment. His judgment is to every man, regardless of your works, whether they are tough, whether they are evil. You will be judged. You will not escape his judgment. For he is known. That's the only way he is known, is by his judgment. You will not escape the judgments of Yahweh's wrath. Hallelujah. And we see here, in as we go to Kephar, in the renewed covenant, he explains unto us that we must exercise. We must cause it to be fruitful in our everyday lives, not just in what we speak. For talk is cheap. Anyone can talk the talk. But the proof is in the doing. The asah, you fashion, you perform yourself unto the Torah. So we must exercise the emunah, the faith, to obtain this virtue, this strength of Yah. 2 Kephar, 2 Peter 1 and 1 says here, Simon Kephar, a servant, he made himself lowly. He humbled himself before Yah. And an apostle of Yahshua HaMashiach, yes, to them who have obtained, yes, like precious emunah. Yes. So when we obtain this emunah, when we garner it, we receive it from Yah. We don't close our lips, we don't close our ears, but we hearken and we furnish our nephesh with this emunah, with this steadfastness in Torah. Only then will it obtain the emunah with us through. We obtain this through the tzedakah, the righteousness of Yah, through his justice, when we judge our own lives, when we allow the Torah to search us. You don't try to hide what is wrong in your lev, in your mind, from Yah, because he can see it. You don't try to hide it from your hope. You don't try to hide it from your art, but you confess. That's the righteousness of Yah. You confess, you judge yourself. You allow the justice of Yah to open you up. And then you will obtain the emunah and our Redeemer through Yahshua HaMashiach. He says, the free, unmerited ahava and favor and shalom. Isn't that beautiful? He gives us all these things that we need. Unmerited ahava, favor, shalom, be multiplied. It be multiplied to you through the knowledge, through the knowledge of Yahweh. Now, we all think that we have the knowledge. The world thinks that they have the knowledge. They have been taught precepts, concepts by other men. They have not opened their minds to the Ruah of Yah to be taught, but they think that they have the knowledge. And they'll tell you, all knowledge is, it's information that I get from here, that I get from there, and I believe it. Well, that's not knowledge. Knowledge is that by observation. First of all, you don't talk about it. It's not something that you speak. That's not knowledge. It comes from observation. From applying yourself, keeping your mouth shut, watching, listening, learning, from observation that you come to an understanding. You come to an awareness. You come to realize and comprehend how one operates. That's the knowledge of Yah. That through hearkening, listening, observing his Torah, you come to an understanding of how Yah works. How he moves, not through your own emotions and feelings. For he has granted us the understanding to understand how he does things. He means for us to understand. That's the knowledge of Yah. Through the knowledge of him that has called us. He has called us, each and every one of us today, to be here. I bless him for that, that I am here. Only by his favor. Not because of anything special that I am, that I have done, but simply because from the foundations, before anything was formed, that he chose me from out of my mother's womb. Even though I was born and shaped in iniquity, just like any other man, but still, by the dawn, by his favor, he chose me. He called me. He called each and every one of us to honor. And unto virtue. Yes, yes. He calls us unto virtue to be valiant, to be powerful, to have the substance of his Torah, that we will not bend, we will not break, no matter what trial, what persecution comes our way. We have that virtue. You will stand on the emunah of Yah. He has called us for that, Yisrael, for no other purpose but to stand on his Emunah through the virtue that he has given us through Yahshua HaMashiach. And he says, through this virtue, through this honor, whereby they are given, he has opened his love and given freely, for he sent his one and only begotten Son to die upon that stake for the redemption of our sins. He has given to us exceeding great and precious promises. The same promise that he gave unto Abraham, he gives it to us, Yisrael. He said unto Abraham, you will be fruitful. You will multiply. Your zera, your seed will be as the sands of the sea. He gives us that same promise, that we be fruitful and multiply in his Torah, in his ways, in knowledge and understanding of him. He's given us the same precious promise, that by these promises, that you might be partakers of the revealed nature. He reveals his nature to us, Yisrael. He reveals it, his ways, his thoughts, his Torah to his chosen people, not to the world. That is a precious thing when someone reveals, they open themselves up to you. They share with you their fights, their struggles. They share, and that's what we all should do today. We are here. We are the family of Emunah. We are the ones of light, precious faith. We reveal unto each other. We open our lips. We don't hide from each other. We don't seek to be away from each other, but we gather together. We reveal ourselves just as Yah has revealed himself to us, that we are one in the Emunah of Yah. They are given to us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these you might be partakers of the revealed nature, the very substance of Yahshua HaMashiach, having escaped. Have we escaped today, Yisrael? Dawid said, my nephesh has escaped like a bird out of the snare of the fowler, out of the snares of sin and corruption. Yahweh has made a way for us to escape, Yisrael. Having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. We know that all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life. These things, they are not of Yah. So we must escape the corruption that is in this world through the lust. Corral your lust. It can be done. Yah has given us the tools. We don't have to lust for things, cars, houses. We should not lust. We should not desire those things. All that we need, Yisrael, is in Yahshua HaMashiach. He supplies everything. Everything that pertains unto the high, the life, to the Siddiqah, the set apartness. He supplies that. He gives us that before we even ask, because he knows what we need. And besides this, besides escaping the corruptions, besides this, giving all, kol, the entirety of your being, the wholeness of yourself, giving all diligence, great attention, great effort, great persistence, great care, all diligence. You must give all. Kol. Yah is not going to take 50%. He's not going to take that. He's not going to accept it. He accepts only all. Kol. That's what he accepts. All diligence, persistence, and effort. You add. Before you add, you must start with something. You must start with something. He gives us that which we're to start with. Add to your Emunah, your faith, your steadfastness in Torah. You must get that right first. You must get that right first. That's the first step. That your emunah, your security, your assurance in Torah is strong. Then after that, you add the virtue power, the strength, the ability to fight, the ability to war in this warfare. Again, you add virtue, the strength, the power, the substance, the excellence, the might, the valiant nature of Yah. Those are all characteristics of a warrior. We must all be warriors, Israel. Yes, we must have the virtue, the valiant, strong nature that even Yahshua had.
Yes, he did.
And he says, after that, you add to your virtue, to your high yield, you add the knowledge. The diat.
Yes.
The comprehension and understanding of how Yah operates. And you gain that through the observation, through watching, learning, listening. You add to your virtue that knowledge. And many times, Israel, we feel, or not we feel, we know. We know that our emunah is not what it should be. We know that. We understand that our emunah is not where Yah wants it to be. And so we see here an example in Lucas when even the disciples that walked with Yahshua, they understood that I need more. I need more. I'm not where I need to be. So we see here in Lucas 17 and 5, they made a statement to Yahshua when they sensed that they were lacking in this area. They said, the apostles said to Yahshua, they said, increase, increase, multiply it, cause it to flourish, cause it to become numerous, increase our emunah. That should be our cry today, Israel, that Yah will increase our emunah, that he will increase our steadfastness in his Torah, in his commandments, that he will increase our stability. We must be stable. We cannot be as those that are shaken to and fro, carried by every wind of doctrine. We cannot be that way. We must be firm in what Yah has commanded us. They said, increase our emunah, Yahshua. And the world thinks that, you know, if you have emunah, the church has taught us this, that, you know, the things that you garner in this world, that is a result of how strong your emunah is. Oh, my faith is so strong. I have this $300,000 house that I'm in debt with. I will be paying for it for 40 years with a mortgage, maybe 50 if I live that long. But they think that is an extension of their emunah. Or I have this car that is a $600 a month payment, and then with the insurance, it bumps it on up to $800. But this is the blessings from my faith. It's foolishness. It's foolishness. That doesn't mean that you have great faith. That's a lie. Yahshua said this when they asked him to increase their faith. And Yahshua said to them, if you had emunah, even as the grain, one grain, not a handful, just one grain, one seed, one grain of a mustard seed. One grain. So it doesn't matter how great that you think your faith is. That doesn't equal anything with Yah. Because you have this, you have obtained that, land, house is rich. If you have the emunah as a grain, for the little that a Sadiq man has, it is greater. It is more in abundance than all the riches of the wicked. If you had emunah as a grain of mustard seed, you might say to this mulberry tree, yes, to your sins, yes, to your corruptions, yes, be you plucked up by the root.
Hallelujah.
That's Emunah right there. When you take all the things that are in your life and you cast them away from you, the sin, the corruption, knowing that they are not of Yah, you take those things that grow, that fester in your life, they are not the fruitfulness of Yah. You take those things and you command them to be cast into the sea. You command that sin and corruption to be cast away from you. And it obeys you. That's the Emunah of Yah. When you clean yourself up, you don't allow the things to grow on your lair. You chop them up by the root. You cast them away as far as the east is from the west. And then you walk in the power, in the virtue, in the high yield, the strength of Almighty Yah. That's Emunah right there. For we should have the Emunah, the faithfulness of Yah. For he is faithful to us. He has not turned away from us, even through all of our sins, all of our corruptions, our unworthiness. He has not turned away. He corrects us. He reproves us. He straightens us out. He rebukes us. But he doesn't turn his love away from us, because he is faithful to us. In Jeremiah, here in Lamentations, he shows us the faithfulness that Yah has towards us. Lamentations 3 and 21. He says this. We'll find out what the this is. He tells us on down. But he said, this I recall. I bring it to my remembrance. I refresh it daily. I restore it in my mind. He said, I recall it to mind. Therefore, have I tikvah. I have an expectation from Yah. No, not a hope, not a wish. As Zakeh Ramiah told us last evening, not that, but I simply have an expectation. I expect, I wait, knowing, not hoping, not perhaps tense, but I know, I wait knowing that the solution, Ayada, I know that the solution is coming, that the change is coming. That's tikvah. It's not, you know, a happen chance that it's going to happen. No, you expect it because you know that it's going to come. That is our tikvah. He said, have our tikvah. It is because, it's because of Yahweh's steadfast, his steadfast loving kindness. He is so kind. He has such affection for his house. And it's steadfast. It's always there. It's fixed. It's unchanging. Yahweh's steadfast loving kind. It is unchanged. It doesn't change. Through his anger with us, through his wrath, he still has loving kindness. He still has affection for us. He still has it. He's faithful. It is because of Yahweh's steadfast loving kindness that we are not consumed. It is because his compassion. His compassions fail not. So this is what Jeremiah recalled to mind. He recalled to mind the steadfast loving kindness of Yah, his compassion, his tenderness to his house. He says, these compassions, they are renewed. They are made fresh. Every morning. They are rejuvenated every morning. They are restored unto us every morning. When your eyes open, his compassion is there, Yisrael. Every morning they are renewed. And he says here, great, Rab, in the Hebraic. Great, abundant. I like this definition right here. It is abundant in quantity, which is much, but not only in quantity, but in quality. In quality. It doesn't get any better. It's the best. As the world would say, it's grade A. It's the best. His rod, great in quantity. It is enough. It's just enough. It's enough. It's not too much. It's not just a little bit too little, but it is enough. Great is your faithfulness. Your faithfulness, your Emunah, oh Yahweh. For Yahweh, he is trustworthy. He is. He never lets us down. So great is the faithfulness. It is abundant in quality and quantity. And it is plenteous. Great is your faithfulness, O Yahweh. Towards who? Towards us. Toward each and every one of his children, of Israel. Great. It is great. There's nothing that's going to get any better. You're not going to find anything better out there in the world. You're not going to find anything that's going to soothe your love any more than the faithfulness of Yah. It gets no better than that. And then he says here in Lamentations 3, verse 24, he says, Yahweh. Yahweh is my portion. He's my inheritance. He is my allotment in this life. You know, people leave inheritance to their children. Most of the time they leave them debt, something to fight over, a house, a car. The reading of the will comes and everyone is pissed off because they didn't get what they wanted, what they thought they should have. But Jeremiah said here, I don't need any of that. He says, Yahweh is my portion. My Abba, he is my father. He is my portion. He's all that I need. He is my inheritance. He is my allotment in this life. He's my share. I'll take that. Yahweh, that's what Jeremiah said here. Yahweh is my portion, saith my nephesh. Therefore, here's that word again, will I tigvah. I will expect him because I know that he's coming. He's going to show up. I will expect him. He is my tikvah. He is my solution to every problem, to every circumstance. It's Yahweh. Therefore will I tikvah in him. Verse 25 says here that Yahweh, he is tough. Is not Yahweh tough? He's been tough to us, Yisrael. He's rescued us from the filth, from the mire of sin. And many times we forget that. We don't think about how tough Yah is to us. We get wrapped up in our feelings. We get wrapped up in our childish, immature emotions. And we forget how tough Yahweh has been to us. We better stop forgetting Yisrael, y'all. You better remember, Zakar, how tough Yah is. He's tough to me. I know that. He is tough to me. He's been tough to us, Yisrael, y'all. He's been bountiful and sweet unto us. He's been pleasant. And he's been loving. He's been tough. Yahweh is tough to them that wait. Teach me to wait, Yah. Teach me how to wait so I may receive that tub. That's when you receive the tub of Yah. That's when you understand the tub of Yah. When you learn how to wait. Let us learn how to wait, Yisrael, Yah. To look patiently for Yahweh. Not to let our eyes be turned to the left, to the right, or back. We shouldn't look back. Let us always look forward, looking to Yahshua, the author and the finisher of what? Of our Emunah. He's the one that begins our Emunah, and he's the one that our Emunah ends in Yahshua HaMashiach. He is the perfect example for us, Yisrael. So let us wait for Yah. And he is Tov also to the Nefesh. When you seek him with all that is within you, he is Tov to your Nefesh, to this inward man. When you seek him, when you diligently inquire, you search for him. We must do that, Yisrael. Let us begin to seek Yahweh, to diligently require of him what we should do, how we should do it, when we should do it. And then we will be filled with his Tov and his Emunah. And not only the Emunah, but with the virtue, the Hayil, the ability to war, to fight the tough fight of Emunah with strength, with power, with substance, and with the excellence, the might of Almighty Yah through Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. Toda Yah for all things. And be encouraged, call Yisrael in the Emunah and in the virtue of Yahshua HaMashiach. Toreya. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Way. You cannot get around that Yisrael, the mitzvah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. And it was beautifully and eloquently laid out with soundness, with truth. Hallelujah. That even the little ones can understand what was spoken concerning this Emunah, the battle, and what we must add, hallelujah, to our Emunah. Hallelujah. It cannot be brought forth any clearer than what we just heard, Yisrael, the instructions of Almighty Yahweh concerning Emunah. And we must have it, Yisrael. We cannot please, as we have heard from our king. We cannot please Almighty Yahweh without Emunah. Hallelujah. At this time, I want to ask our Akh Shimriy if he will come forth. Hallelujah. As we continue this teaching concerning this fight, the battle of our Emunah. Hallelujah. Yahshua HaMashiach. Akh Shimriy.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Conditions, I don't know about you, but my leg is being fed. And if we as a people can't see the virtue, what Yah is doing, even here, and even as me being the big brother, because I'm older than these are, I've watched Yowshibyah, Yeromiah, Wasadat. And even as we had more young men here, it was always something about me spending time with him and him and this one. And a lot of the other ones I would not, because I come from that type of background. But if we as the people of Yah, and those of you that are listening, if we can't see what Yah is doing here, if we can't see the virtue, hallelujah, and if we can't see the strength that Yah has put in these young men through this man of Yah, allowing Yah to use him. And I know he don't like for me to exalt him, but I will anyway. I'm not afraid of him because I know him. Hallelujah. I know his Ahava. Hallelujah. And that's how we as a people, we should know those that we dwell amongst. Hallelujah. For that's what Torah says. We should know those who we labor amongst. Hallelujah. And that's what Yah intends for it to be as a people. And even as this morning at breakfast, as I watched as Reok left out, and he asked our Akh Shimriy, let's take some pictures. Show the people how we should dress as a Kodesh people of Yah. And as I'm standing there and I'm watching my younger sisters, Zakiya and Shikanya and Yawasadox Isha Yorona. And I'm just enjoying the camaraderie. Yes. And as a people, yes, as a family, yes, that's the way we should be as a people of YAH. But even as a young man, I've always loved family reunions and those type of things, just to be around my kinsmen then as a young man. But I enjoyed that atmosphere because that is the tough fight of Emunah. Do we understand? That is the tough fight of Emunah. Regardless of Shimri's this way, Yowshibyah's that way, but we fight the fight. This sister's that way, but we fight the fight of Emunah. Hallelujah. That we endure. No, we don't run off. We don't get sideways towards this one or that one. Because Rayok and Raphael, they're not always going to be here. Hallelujah. They're going to go on. I'm going to go on. And as our precious young ox said, we need to put this into our little ones so they can stand as a people. Hallelujah. That they will have it more than what we have. Hallelujah. Because they haven't been exposed to what's out there. Hallelujah. And that's how we should be as a people. I enjoy that. No schisms, no isms. It's just a family. And those of you that are listening, this is what YAH intends for his people. To live amongst each other. Hallelujah. And even if you're not living here, you live in the Ruah. Hallelujah. And you endure. That's what YAH intends for his people. This is the fight. The fight of enduring one the other. Hallelujah. This is the fight. This is what YAH intends for his people. But the world has trained us to think, as our young ox said, oh, to believe for material things. That's not a fight. A faggot can get a Cadillac. Hallelujah. That's not a fight. That's not Emunah. It's when we put aside ourselves. Hallelujah. We get rid of the things that's not of YAH within us. That we stand as a people. Hallelujah. That's the fight. You can't do this alone. Satan will rip you up. We can't do this alone. We need one the other. Hallelujah. We need one the other. Hallelujah. This pinky is no greater than this thumb. But they make up the hand. And the hand makes up the strength to fight this fight. Hallelujah. We need one the other. Hallelujah. And as we heard earlier, YAH has an order. And you can't fight a battle without an order, people. We can't fight a battle without an order. He has a protocol. Hallelujah. He has ranks. And that's what makes the strength. And that's what we need as a people of YAH. Has nothing to do with numbers. You look at the world today. Has nothing to do with numbers. That's trash. As I've heard over the years here, as the man of YAH would always say, I'd rather have a few lamb than 1,000 goats. He's always said, I can get more done with those few sheep. Because of why? Because of the protocol, because of the strength. Everyone knows their place. Hallelujah. Everyone knows their place. And as we heard earlier, if you abide in your place and you just maintain that, what you do, not trying to be the smartest, not trying to know everything, but you abide in what you know and you perfect that, and that strengthens the body. Hallelujah. That strengthens the body, just what you know. You're abiding in that, not trying to know everything. Hallelujah. 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 And that's what we need as a people of YAH. We need this condition of YAH. That's why YAH intends for us to keep his feast days. That we come together with a true heart. That he can wash out this trash that's in us. That separate us. Hallelujah. That's what that's why he intends for us to come together, to live amongst each other, so we can know one the other, have that true ahava one for the other. Regardless of what goes on, what happens, you bounce back and you keep it going. You don't run off, you don't separate. That's not a movement, that's not the true ahava of YAH. We can't teach our little ones that. Because believe me, they watch and they know and they see. And you wonder, why is she acting this way? Because she learned it from you, mama. Hallelujah. Why is he acting that way? Because he learned it from you, daddy. That's why he's that way. Hallelujah. That's what y'all wants us to do. This is the fight. This is the fight. To be family oriented into the things of Yah. This is the fight. This is the fight. Hallelujah. I'm going to start here in Maccabees 9 and 24. It says fight. It says fight the sacred. What is sacred? It's a set apart. Not the fight of this world. This is a set apart fight that we're fighting as a people of Yah. It has nothing to do with what they're fighting for out there. It's totally opposite. Yes, it is. This is sacred. It's hidden from the mind of this world. They think we're crazy. They think we don't know what we're doing. Hallelujah. But what we're doing is lining up with what the book says. Hallelujah. It's sacred. Hallelujah. It's sacred. It's dedicated. It's dedicated. Are we a dedicated people today? Help me, y'all. It says dedicated. And it says dear to. Is this fight for Almighty Yah? Is it dear to us? Is it dear to our love? Hallelujah. That's what sacred is. It says fight the sacred fight of Emunah. The sacred, dedicated, dear to. You take it to the heart. Hallelujah. You take it to the heart. It bothers you when you haven't done right. Hallelujah. You can't sleep. You're sideways. And you have to get upon your knees to get it right. That's the sacred fight. That's the fight that we need to fight of Emunah. To where it bothers you. Like y'all missing it. I need you, y'all. I need more of you, y'all. Within my lab. That's the sacred fight of Emunah. That's the fight where y'all intend for us to fight as a people of Yah. Hallelujah. This is the fight. Hallelujah. To love my heart. To be kinder to my heart. To tell the truth. To tell them the truth and stand by it. This is the fight Yah intends for his people. Hallelujah. It says, fight the sacred and the noble. The noble battle for Emunah. What is noble? It's a choice. A choice, an excellent. It says, an excellent battle of Emunah. When something is excellent, there's no additive. There's no preservatives. Hallelujah. There's nothing in it but true Emunah. That's excellent. There's no room for nothing. Hallelujah. It's a mindset. It's a heart that's set to please Almighty Yah. To do what is required of us as a people. To serve our Abba. Hallelujah. That's what it is. Hallelujah. Excellent. For Emunah. It says, thereby the just providence of our ancestors may become kinder to our nation and take vengeance on the accursed tyrant. Hasatan, the accursed tyrant. We put this in our little ones. That it's in them so richly, as I said earlier, that when they grow and when they begin to mature, they take it on. They take it to heart because that's all they know. Yeah. They know nothing else. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Totally up. We must fight this sacred battle. It's a sacred battle. It's noble battle of Emunah. It's a fight of Emunah conditions of Yah. As we heard Akh Yowshibyah say, it's nothing else out there. It's nothing out there that's going to appease this nefesh of ours. Why do you think the world is in such a haywire? Because nothing satisfies them. They run from one thing for a few, and they run to another thing for a few. And it doesn't last. Nothing lasts out there. As I'm driving, sometimes you can see people with their garages up. You understand? And you look at all this stuff piled in there. You would think, when does it stop? But it makes my mind go back to the flesh. It's never satisfied. Garages full of stuff where they can't even close the doors. It's just packed. And that's what this flesh does. If we're led by our flesh, if we're not fighting the fight of Emunah, we will end up the same way. Full of lust. Never satisfied. But if we, as a people, if we apply our heart, if we fight this fight of Emunah, those things we won't be taken by, as I shall read earlier, or later. Hallelujah. It says here, it says, I have fought a tough fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the Emunah. It says, I have finished. Do you know when we have finished something? As a people striving to please y'all, when you have finished something, it's complete.
Sure it is.
It's satisfied.
Yes, sir.
There is nothing left to do.
Yes.
As we would say, as I was coming up, it's a wrap.
Yes. Come on,
and it says, I have kept the Emunah. When we keep something, when we keep it, it is stored away. Hallelujah. It's sealed.
Yes, it is.
It's sealed. Nothing's going to break that seal.
Yes.
Nothing is going to corrupt that.
That's right.
It says, I have kept it.
Yes.
That means it was enriched within us.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing could get in. We guarded it with all that we had that was in us.
Yeah.
That's when you know that you're in this walk with Yah. When you keep what you hear.
Yeah.
Not that you hear it. Hallelujah. Not that you hear it and you walk out and you begin back into your same way. No, you keep it. It's kept. Hallelujah. Then you may finish this walk. Hallelujah. It's kept. You're not going to allow anything in. You guard it with all that you have. Till you can't guard it anymore and you just stand. And you wait on Almighty Yah. And you bring it before Him, say, Yah, I've done all I can do now. So I just stand, Yah. I have to believe on you.
Yes.
As my young ox said, just a grain of mustard seed.
Yes, that's what
just one grain. And you have to stand on that one grain.
Yes,
hallelujah. Yes. Once you've done all you can do and you know you've done it,
yes,
to keep it,
yes,
to keep your Emunah,
yes,
to keep this fight.
Yes.
And you just wait upon Yah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
It says, I have fought the fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the Emunah. 2 Timothy 4 and 8. I'm sorry if I didn't tell you where I was reading from. It says, henceforth there is laid up for me. Do we hear that? It's laid up. When something is laid up, it's reserved. It's kept back. It's laid up for me. For us, conditions of Yah. This is what Timothy is saying. He's saying it's laid up for him. He knows this. It says, it's laid up for me,
yes,
a crown.
Yes, a crown.
What is a crown?
Yes, yes, yes.
What is a crown?
Help me,
it's a mark,
yes,
of royal,
sure it is,
or general,
like that,
exalted rank.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Yah has for us, people.
Yes.
It's a crown.
Yes.
It's a crown,
mm-hmm,
that He's going to put upon His people.
Yes.
Almighty Yah, who created,
yes,
everything,
yes, yes,
for simple people as us,
yes,
He has laid it up for us. Do our minds even
hallelujah
realize that?
Hallelujah.
He has laid it up for us,
yes,
for His people,
yes,
a crown,
yes,
an exalted rank,
yes,
that we shall rule.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That we shall be His people.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
It is a kodesh,
mm-hmm,
gift,
sure,
given,
yes,
and to this key word, the genuine,
yes,
servants,
yes, talk to us,
of Almighty Yah,
yeah,
and Yahshua.
Hallelujah.
That's what a crown is.
Hallelujah.
What else is there that you could even compare to that?
Nothing.
You can't compare anything to that.
I will not.
You can't.
It
says, henceforth, Timothy 4 and 8, therefore is laid up for me a crown of kodeshness, which Yah, the righteous judge, shall give me in that day. And not to me only, this is Timothy speaking, it says, but to all them also that Ahava, his appearing. Those that are Hava, and as the world say, love,
yeah,
his appearing, his coming. And how do you know that you are Ahava, his appearing? Because as I said earlier, all that lies within you. You follow peace. You follow, as my young ox said, virtue. Hallelujah. We follow all those things because we're looking for his appearing, that we may reign with him, that we may abide with him, our precious Abba. That's how we know we are Ahava, his appearing. His appearing, because everything that we are striving for is focused upon seeing our Abba and reigning with our Abba as a people. What else do we have? What else is there? What else is there? That's nothing else. That's nothing else. We must follow after these things, conditional y'all. We need these things to fight this battle. 1 Timothy 6:10. These are the things that we need, the weapons that we need to fight this battle, conditional y'all. It says, for the Ahava of money is the root of all evil. And as we see this world today, we know that that's so true. For someone to do you wrong, and if you look back, why are they doing this? Why is it this way? Why is the world the way it is today? Because of what Torah says. Because of money, for greedy gain, the lust of the flesh. It's the root of all this evilness. It's the root. Because why? Because they take money and they satisfy their wicked flesh. It's the root of it. And we can say what we will or say what we may. But this is what the book says. It says, for the Ahava of money is the root of all evil, which while some covet, after they have erred from the Emunah and pierce themselves through with many sorrows. Because the flesh is never satisfied. And regardless of what you buy, what you get, what you, as our Akh Yowshibyah said, regardless of what you get in this world, it's still not going to satisfy you. It's not going to satisfy you. Hallelujah. That's why you got to go and buy something else 6 months later or a year later. That's why this house is not going to satisfy you. So you got to buy another house. That's all the rich do. It makes my mind think about an article I was reading night before last. It's a man, I guess out in Iowa, Minnesota, somewhere. He had him and his wife, two girls and a boy, I think, or two boys and a girl. The man was a millionaire. I think he made $1 million a year after everything paid off. It was a nursing establishment that he was the owner. He started it. And this man goes in the house. He kills his wife. Now, they're in a mansion. They showed the mansion and everything. Yes, $2 million. A mansion. You would think they got pictures on Facebook of them on the boat and pictures beside a Lamborghini and his son and his two little daughters. He goes in the house. Conditions of Yah. And we think this thing is not real. He goes in the house. He kills his wife. He goes to another room. Gun downs his son. Boy ain't no older than maybe 17. Kills his two little daughters, all in separate rooms. He goes to the garage and kills himself. All the neighbors like, oh, they're such a loving family. That's what they always say. And you think, if they got money, they're rich, they're millionaires, what makes a man do this? He has no Emunah. He knows not Yah. He has not the fight of Almighty Yah in his bosom. Hallelujah. And we're going to seek money and run after these things. Hallelujah. We think this fight is not real, but it is, conditional of Yah. We take the things of grant. We take the things of Yah for granted. Hallelujah. We take it for granted, conditional of Yah. And as Yowshibyah said, another point he said, we forget. We forget where Yah has brought us from. We forget. We get high-minded. And we strain at a net, as the Torah says, and we swallow a camel. The smallest little things we're sideways about. Hallelujah. And that's how we are as a people of Yah. We must allow Yah to take us back. Yah, take us back where you found us, Yah. You didn't have to, but you did. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. These are the things we need. We need to fight this fight, Kedushas of Yah. We need to fight this battle. This is a battle. This is nothing to play with. This is a battle. We need to take these things to heart. When we hear the Torah of Yah, we need to take it to heart. Hallelujah. Help me, Yah. Help me. He says, fight the tough fight of Emunah. Lay hold of eternal life.
Yes, I will. These words.
Timothy 6 and 12. It says, whereunto you also have called and has professed a tough profession before many witnesses. Have we not professed that? We separate ourselves from our immediate families. Have we not? We have professed as a people of Yah. We start out with a lot of people here. And I don't care how strong and how spiritual you think you are. When you live with the people and when they begin to depart, you feel that. But we, the ones here that Yah still has here, and those of you that are still listening, Yah has given you something. You've separated yourself. We have separated ourselves. Hallelujah. We have allowed them to go on. We are fighting the fight of Emunah. You're not going to tell me that doesn't bother you to have a son leave. Hallelujah. To have a daughter to depart from you. To have a sister, biological, or whatever. That does affect you. And you have to fight the Emunah to keep walking. Hallelujah. You have to have the Emunah. You have to have that fight of Emunah to keep standing. You're not going to tell me. I've seen the man of Yah cry. Even though that wasn't his biological, but he was a man of Yah. Hallelujah. So he puts his heart into that. Or else he would never have shed a tear when those who have left. But we as a people, we're standing. That's what Yah intends for people to do. Hallelujah. He intends for us to stand. Yes, that you feel that. I don't care what you say. You do feel it. If you're not cold, if you have any, just out of a natural sense, you feel that. You're not going to tell me that, to have your mother to leave. But we stand in Emunah. Hallelujah. We fight the fight of Emunah. We let them go on. Let them do their thing. Whatever it may be. We stand as a people of Yah. We fight the fight of Emunah. Hallelujah. We all have cried. We all have felt some kind of way. Because you get attached to those people.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You do get attached.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But we have to stand for Almighty Yah.
Yes,
we need to be more attached to Him
than
any of that. Any of them. We get more attached to Him. Hallelujah. That's what we should be attached to. Hallelujah. Because that is the purpose of Emunah. It's going to be tried. If your moon is not tried, then you don't have any. Because when your moon is tried, then you stand and you know that I'm standing for my Abba. I'm standing for my Abba. The moon is going to be tried. There's going to be battles. And as we heard earlier from our Akh Yowshibyah, we should want to be tried. We should welcome those. We should be happy when we're tried. That's how we know we're in the moon of Yah, because we're being tried. This world is not being tried today.
No.
They come on Sunday and play church and go right back to what they was doing. You tried this way. In this walk, you tried. When you live this way, you tried. Hallelujah. When you're serving Yah, you're being tried. Because He's going to separate you from all those things. If you're serving Yah, if you're sincere, if you're real, you're going to be tried. Hallelujah. You should want to be tried. If you take it to heart, if you're sincere. You should want to be tried as a people of Yah. I want to be tried. Hallelujah. We should want to be tried. 1 Peter 1 and 2. It's talking about the elect. It says, first Kephar, elect according to the foreknowledge of Yah, our Abba, through a set apart of the Ruah. It's not the same as what they call the Ruah today. It's a set apart. It says to obedience and sprinkling of the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. The free unmerited Ahava is free. He doesn't charge. It's free. Only thing we have to do is abide in it and stand in it. It says the free unmerited Ahava in favor to you and shalom be multiplied. And it will be multiplied. Goodness of Yah. It says, blessed be Yahweh, the Abba of our master Yahshua HaMashiach, which according to his abundant kindness, as we heard earlier, his kindness, we have nothing we can charge Yah with. We have nothing. Yah has been kind to us, as we heard earlier. He has been kind. Hallelujah. He's kept us. He's kept us through all that has transpired here, through our lives. He's kept us. We're still sitting here. We're still abiding and listening to the truth. Hallelujah. We can't charge y'all with nothing. His kindness. I know I can't. I have a dangerous job. I can die any day. Hallelujah. Back roads, driving a tractor trailer. Whatever y'all's will is. Hallelujah. We can die any day. Cutting trees, hallelujah. Climbing trees, cutting them with saws, hallelujah. We can die any day. So Yah has been kind to us. We're still here today. We can lift our hands and give him Todah. Hallelujah. He has begotten us again. First Kephar, 1 and 3. He says, he has begotten us again to a lively tikvah by the resurrection. Hallelujah. Of Yahshua HaMashiach from the dead. It says, 1 Peter 1 and 4. I'll probably read on down to 1 Peter 1 and 9. It says, to an inheritance. Hallelujah. Incorruptible and undefiled, and that fades not away, reserved in the Shemayim for you, for us. It's incorruptible, it's reserved, it's set aside for his people. Those that fight this Emunah, those that fight with this Emunah. Hallelujah. Until the end. Hallelujah. We're going to be tried. Hallelujah. And I shall read an account. I'm going to go back to Maccabees, but I got an account that I'm going to read of torture. And we search our own hearts to see, could we handle this? But I'll go back and read it. Hallelujah. It says, that's reserved in the Shemayim for you, for us. First Kephar 1 and 5, who are kept. Hallelujah. It says, who are kept by the power of Yah. And how are we kept? As it goes on to say, through the Emunah. Hallelujah. Through the Emunah of Almighty Yah. It says, to salvation, ready to be revealed. Hallelujah. In the last time. Hallelujah. Ready to be revealed in the last time. When all this is coming down. When we have that Emunah, when we stand, hallelujah, and when it's all coming down, y'all's going to have a people that's going to stand, and they're going to marvel like, who are these people? Who are those people? Hallelujah. That's what the Emunah is going to do for his people, those that fight this tough fight. As I always say, this race is not given unto the swift, nor unto those that are strong, but it's given unto his people, those that endure. Until the end. Hallelujah. Peter 1 and 6, it says, wherein you greatly rejoice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Though now for a reason, if need be, you have been burdened by various trials. And we're going to be burdened by various trials. But as I said earlier, you stand. You fight the fight of Emunah. And first of all, you know we always have to, the problem starts where? It starts with me. Hallelujah. And that's where we must look. It starts with us. It's not your ark or your hope. It starts with you. You search your heart. I search my heart. That's how the problems are resolved. That's how they're resolved. As I was talking with Rayok, I think we may have been by the gym or somewhere. And he was talking about marriage. Maybe in the plaza area. He says, marriages, in a sense, he's saying, are simple. They're simple. A marriage wasn't for us to be back and forth. And because he said, it's the little small things. The little small things. And it blows up to something big. And if you think about it, as he said, it's really nothing. It's really nothing. But we're so tied up within ourselves and what we think we know. Hallelujah. We don't want to see ourselves. Hallelujah. And that's how we are as a people of YAH. And that's what keeps it going. Because we don't want to see ourselves. We don't want to humble ourselves. That's the fight of Emunah. That's fighting of this faith. Just humble ourselves and say, okay, even though I know I'm not wrong, even though I think I know that I'm not wrong, I'm going to go and humble myself and keep peace. Hallelujah. And follow the Emunah of YAH. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What was our 1 Peter 1 and 6? It says, burdened by the various trials. Okay, 1 Peter 1 and 7. It says that the trial, testing of your Emunah, being much more precious, hallelujah, being much more precious than gold. It says that perishes. It's more precious. If it's more precious than gold, then it doesn't perish. Because gold perishes. Hallelujah. It says, though it be tried with the fire, with the trials, with the ups and downs. It's being tried. It says, might be found to praise and honor at the appearing of Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 1 and 8, it says, whom having not seen, it says, your Ahava, in whom though now you see him not, yet believing, you rejoice with joyful, unspeakable, and full of honor and praises. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 1 and 9. It says, receiving the end of your Emunah, even the salvation of your nephesh. Yes. Hallelujah. So we as a people, we must fight this fight of Emunah. And I'm going to go back here to Maccabees. I want to read this account before I continue. As if you recall, I read in first, I started out in Maccabees 9 and 24. It says, fight the sacred and noble battle for the Emunah. But if you read before that in 4th Maccabees 9 and 24, I'm going to start at the beginning. It says, I'm reading now Maccabees 9 and 1. It says, why do you delay? These are some Hebrews that are being tried. But all this is going to tie back. It's going to tie back into the first scripture I read. Fight the noble and sacred fight of Emunah. Thereby the just providence of our ancestors may become kinder to our nation and take vengeance on the accursed tyrant. Okay, it says, why do you delay, O tyrant? For we are ready to die. Rather than transgress our ancestral commandments. Do we have that type of Emunah? Hallelujah. It says, we are ready to die. Do what you're going to do. It goes on to say, it says, Maccabees 9:2, it says, we are obviously putting our forefathers to shame unless we should practice ready obedience to the Torah and to Moshe, our counselor. It says, tyrant and counselor of Torahlessness, in your hatred for us, do you not pity us more than we pity ourselves? For we consider this pity of yours, which ensures our safety through transgression of the Torah, to be more grievous than death itself. Than death itself. Hallelujah. These Hebrews are ready to die. They're ready. Are we ready to die? Are we ready to die? This is an example. What Yah has for us. Hallelujah. Do we feel that way? Hallelujah. Help me, Yah. We need this Emunah, this fight. We need it to fight this fight. It says, you are trying to terrify us by threatening us with death, by torture, as though a short time ago you learned nothing from Eleazar. It says Eleazar was a, he was a known man of virtue, as Akh Yowshibyah talked of earlier. He was a known man of virtue that prayed unto Yah, that waited on Yah, that was taken to death's doors and waited on Yah, believed Yah, and Yah delivered him. It says, you are terrifying us by threatening us with death, by torture, as though a short time ago you learned nothing from Eleazar. It says, and if the aged men of the Hebrews, because of their faith, live meekly while enduring torture, it will be even more fitting that we young men should die, hallelujah, despising your cohesive tortures, which our age instructors also overcame. Hallelujah. So we shall overcome, conditions of Yah. It says, I'm going to read all the way down to 9 and 17. It says, for we, through this severe suffering and endurance, shall have the prize of virtue. Hallelujah. And shall be with Yah, for from whom we suffer. Hallelujah. It says, but you, because of your bloodthirstiness toward us, will deservedly undergo from Yahweh's justice eternal torment by fire. It says, when they had said these things, the tyrant not only was angry as at those who are disobedient, but also was enraged as at those who were ungrateful. Then at his command, the guards brought forth the elders, having torn off his tunic. They bound his hands and arms with the thongs on each side. When they had worn themselves out, beating him with the scourge, without accomplishing anything, they placed him upon the wheel. Do we hear this condition of Yah? Do we hear this example of torture? What these Hebrews are enduring here. Now that takes an Emunah. That takes an Emunah. It makes my mind go back to when I had an abscess. And I had it for about 2 weeks, I think. And the thing had hurt for so long and for such a long time, to where I began to think in my mind, because I was losing weight, I said, whatever Yah's will be. And Riyak would say, he's not going to die. He's all right. But it got to the point I didn't even feel the pain anymore. It was just, I was just relying on Emunah. Just relying on Emunah. And I was in a state to, well, whatever Yah's will is, let it be. Yah, your will be done. And we got to get to that point, to where we get into the Emunah that we, whatever we're going through, it doesn't even bother us anymore. We leave it in Yah's hands. We endure it with Emunah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's what these Hebrews are going through here. They were in the Emunah. So whatever they did, the torture, whatever they done to them, it didn't even faze them. They looked forward to it. As we heard from Akh Yowshibyah earlier, they looked forward to it. Like, bring it on. What you do, you do. I'm going to stand and serve my Abba. And that's the type of ruach we should have in this fight towards our Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, and they had said these things, the tyrant not only was angry at those who are disobedient, but also was enraged as at those who were ungrateful. Then at his command, the guards brought forth the elders, and having torn off his tunic, they bound his hands and arms with thongs on each side. When they had worn themselves out, beating him with scourges, without accomplishing anything, they placed him upon the wheel. When the noble youth was stretched out, it says a youth. Do we hear this, young man? It says the youth. It says when the noble youth was stretched out around this, his limbs were dislocated and they broken in every member. He denounced the tyrant. He still denounced him, saying, "Most abominable tyrant, enemy of the Shemayims, of judgment, of justice, savage of mind, you are mingling me in this manner." Hallelujah. Not because I'm a murderer. Hallelujah. Not because you've done anything wrong or as one who acts impiously, but because I protect Yahweh's Torah. Hallelujah. Because we protect Yahweh's Torah, we're going to be tried. Hallelujah. HaSatan is going to come at us. Because we must and we know, according to Torah, that we're doing what's right. Hallelujah. What's true? What's a virtue? Hallelujah. And that's why they're being tried. It says, because I protect Yahweh's Torah. And it says, and when the guard said, agree to eat so that you may be released from tortures. And he replied, you abominable lackeys. Your will is not so powerful as to strangle my reason. He said, cut my limbs. Do we hear that? He said, cut my limbs. Burn my flesh. Twist my joints. Hallelujah. Do we have that type of emunah? I need Yah. Hallelujah. It said, twist my joints. It says, through all these tortures, I will conceive you that sons of Hebrews alone are invincible where virtue is concerned. Hallelujah. Where virtue is concerned. It says, while he was saying these things, they spread fire under him. And while fanning the flames, they tightened the wheel further. The wheel was completely smeared with blood, and the heap of coals was being quenched by the dripping of gore. And pieces of flesh were falling off his ankles of the machine. Although the ligaments, joints, his bones were already severed, the courageous youth, worthy of Abraham, he did not even groan. He said, but as though transformed by fire into immortality, he nobly endured the rackings. Imitate me, my brothers, he said. Do we hear that? Imitate me, my brothers, he said. Do not leave your posts. Let us not leave our post, conditions of Yah. Let us stand in this struggle. For Yah said his yoke is easy. He says, do not leave your post in my struggle or renounce our courageous brotherhood. For we have a courageous brotherhood, conditions of Yah. We do. We have a courageous brotherhood. It takes Yah to go against the pulling of this world. You're not going to do it alone. Hallelujah. You're not going to do it without Yah. Eventually, you will get sucked in. Hallelujah. Let me read on. And now I'm back to my scripture that I begin with. It says, do not leave your post in my struggle or renounce our courageous brotherhood. It says, for fight the sacred and noble battle of faith, of Emunah. thereby the just providence of our forefathers may become merciful in our nations and take vengeance on the accursed tyrant. Hallelujah. So let us, as Kedushas, let us fight this fight. Let us stand as a people of Yah. For that's what Yah intends. He tends to weed out. He tends to intertwine the true ones of virtue till we are close knit. Till we are a true family. A true family that will stand up against anything that comes their way. And those of you that have a little age on you, you know, as in growing up, if there was a family in the neighborhood, and if you mess with one, you had to deal with the rest of them. Hallelujah. The young ones may not know, but that's how it was. You fight one brother, next day, here come the rest of them. So that's how we should be as we stand for the truth of Yah, His Torah, our brotherhood. No one should be able to come in here and do anything if they're not of the Emunah of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. So let us stand, Kedushas of Yah. Hallelujah. And Yah Barak you all. Hallelujah. For my life is happy. Hallelujah. Tode you, Ma'aba. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Don't you see the strength in our Akh Yisrael as he spoke these words unto us today concerning this fight of Emunah? He kept saying that we cannot endure this battle alone. That it takes the house of Yisrael working in oneness and one accord, being Ikad. That we have the same mind and the same Emunah. There's only one Emunah. And it is that which has been given by Almighty Yahweh. And it's only by His Emunah, Yisrael, that we stand in battle. As we see our King go before us, He stands. He gives up His life. And it gives a thrust for the next one to go. That he stand in that same power with the boldness of Emunah, that the one has gone before him. Then he goes, and it's continual. That as each one stands by that Emunah, that he endures for the Ahava of the one that went before him. Did not Yahshua, did not he go before us? Did not he say he would go on before and ahead of the house of Yisrael? And he stood the test. He hung on that stake that we may carry the stake in that same fashion. And that we endure all things for what? The house. For the word, the mishpah of Almighty Yahweh, and for Emunah, hallelujah. For he did it all for us, Yisrael, hallelujah. What a beautiful orchestration of the mishpah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh that we have heard from our Akh and our King. And it does not end here. It shall persist and move on as we go through Sukkoth in this process, Yisrael. Our King will come and will stand before us for the word. So use that listening by via of live stream. Continue to be with us as we move on this journey concerning the fight, the battle of our Emunah. For surely, Yisrael, it is a test. But it's a test that we shall not fail as long as we abide in Emunah, Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. I want to barak you, our King, for your steadfast ahava, your loving kindness, your faithfulness. As you have studied, you have searched, you allow the Ruach HaKodesh to move and to speak. Hallelujah. These our King, they would not speak by anything that was written except that which was in the Levim, Yisrael, and given by Almighty Yahweh. Nothing has been rehearsed. We do not sit here and rehearse what we're going to say and what we have to say. It is led by the Emunah and by the Ruach HaKodesh of Almighty Yahweh. This is not some kind of play, but it is truth. It is truth we have been given, Yisrael. We must continue in this, Yisrael, in accordance to the celebration
And even as we heard of the renewed covenant in Yahshua HaMashiach, in this celebration, that we continue, that we move on, Yisrael. The words that we have heard, we allow them to remain in our lap. We do not sell them for anything. But we allow the word and the Torah we have heard to have its most perfect work in our lap, to root out the sin, the iniquity, Yisrael. That we'll be a pleasing people unto Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah, Yahweh. I do want to read this, even concerning the feasts. Hallelujah, Yahweh. In this process, Yisrael, as we move on from the Feast of Trumpets, even the gathering, we have gathered to hear the wonderful testimony, the words of Almighty Yahweh concerning the battles of Emunah. It says here that even the celebration in this day of atonement, it is commanded of us, Yom Kippur, it says right here, it's a time of purging. And that we may understand even the kindness of Almighty Yahweh as we are making reconciliation. It means to cover, to atone, to propitiate. And it's a time that is offered unto Almighty Yahweh great praises and the anointing power of Almighty Yahweh. Now, we have already started the Feast of Trumpets, of Teruah, that is the alarming and the sounding of the shofar, with shout, with the blast of the shofar and our voices lifted unto Almighty Yahweh. And let this rejoicing be a time of loudness and great volume that will cry out unto Almighty Yahweh. It started on Sunday evening, and it shall continue to this Monday, this evening. It says here in Ra'ira, chapter 23, verse 24, a commandment unto Almighty Yah, from Almighty Yahweh, to speak to the children of Yisrael, saying that in the 17th month and in the first day of the month, you shall have a Sabbaton, a memorial of the blowing of the shofar, the trumpets, and it shall be a Kodesh convocation, a mikrah. The Day of Atonement, which shortly it approaches us, Yisrael, Kippur, the time of purging unto Almighty Yahweh. The celebration September, which is Tereshah, on the 24th, which is on Thursday. The feast began at sundown, September the 23rd, on that Wednesday. So we will take that, we will celebrate, we will make the preparations that we are ready, Israel, that we may celebrate the feast of the Almighty Yahweh. He says also here, concerning Sukkoth, which starts shortly after that. The tabernacle Sukkoth, which means booth, is a temporary shelter, a pavilion, a tabernacle, a tent. It says here in Re'ira, Leviticus chapter 23, verse 42, and you shall dwell in booths 7 days, and all that are Yisrael born shall dwell in booths. This celebration, this information, you can find it on our website on YahwehSword.org. It is all laid out, Yisrael. September the 29th, that Thursday begins at sundown, September the 28th. On the Monday. And it also says in Leviticus chapter 23, verse 39, also in the 15th day of the 7th month, we have gathered the fruits of the land. Are we gathering the fruits? Yes. We should be even now gathering the fruits that we have heard from our king today. You gather the fruits of the land, and you shall keep the feast unto Yahweh 7 days. And on the first day shall be a Shabbaton unto Almighty Yahweh. And on the 8th day shall be a Shabbaton. So that should be the great day of Almighty Yahweh, a Sukkoth. And we should celebrate that. You have any questions? Just go there to the website, and it is there, Yisrael. So we barak Yahweh for all things, for the Torah that has gone forth for us today. Let us continue with rejoicing Let us Zakar remember what Almighty Yahweh has done for us and what has been spoken by the mouth of our King today, Yisrael Yah. Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet as we bring this service, this time to end. But yet it shall not end. It shall continue, Yisrael Yah. Hallelujah. Abba Yahweh, we do barak you for this another time and occasion, Yahweh. You have set before us that we shall and we are able to come, Abba Yahweh, into your presence, into your bayah, to be judged, to be rebuked, and also to be exhorted, Abba Yahweh, to remain and to stay in our places, and that we allow the Ruach HaKodesh, Abba Yahweh, and Emunah to have its perfect work in our lives by trials, by tribulations, Abba Yahweh. And we barak you, Yahweh, for feeding us through your messages, our King today, Abba Yahweh. And all things we do barak you, we give you Todah, we do ask those that have traveled, those that are listening, Abba Yahweh, that your Malach, your Melekin, your word, Abba Yahweh, will be encamped around the as the hedge that was encamped about around Eob, that he was protected by every side, Abba Yahweh. So we Todah you, we give you praise. We barak you, Abba Yahweh, for all things. And the precious and wonderful name of Yahshua HaMashiach we declare this day. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah, Yahweh. Hallelujah. Shalom, shalom, Kol Yisrael. Hallelujah.